Okay, everybody fresh?
Yes, sir.
After a nice cup of tea, some biscuits, I don't know what you had.
Jimjan.
Fresh enough?
Yes, sir.
Can we continue?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Now, what we're going to do is make the gyro
non-CV.
Right? Now, you saw earlier I told you, you're putting a weight here, and when this weight is displaced in terms of tilt, or the torque is being applied in terms of tilt, the precision is in terms of drift, right? So same way, if I have another weight which is placed 90 degrees to the first weight, then that would give me a torque in terms of drift, which would give me precision in terms of tilt, right? So basically we have to use two torques, one along the direction of the drift, which will give me precision in terms of tilt, one along the direction of tilt, which gives me precision in terms of drift, right? Now it is difficult to place two weights like this. So what is done is, one weight is displaced slightly, and then resolution of vector. You are aware of resolution of vectors, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Right? So if I have any vector, let's say I have a vector here like this. If I want to resolve this vector, I can have two directions, one here, and depending on this angle, if this is alpha, I will have cos alpha here and sin alpha here, right? Now very simple, depending on how I want it, I can very easily change this direction, and if I have it like this, right, then this angle is now, let's say theta, so along this it is cos theta, and along this it is, so I can change, I can also change the force or the angle, and thereby change the components, right? One is, if this, let's say if this is alpha, then I will have this as A sine, A cos and A sine, or A here along with this for the force. So A can vary, the angle can also vary, and on that basis I can decide what should be the resolution and what should be the forces required. The calculations, as I said, is beyond the scope of this session, so we are not going into derivations, calculations, etc. We are only looking at the understanding. So do you get this point very clear, that instead of having two weights, if I just displace one weight, the components of this would be in two perpendicular directions. Tilt and drift are in perpendicular directions, right? So I'm having a weight slightly displaced, and that will give you the two components and hence the two forces. So when I have the opposition for tilt and opposition for drift, one precision opposing tilt, one precision opposing drift, I can have the gyro not seeking, right? Now basically I have been explaining you this in the videos, but to understand this completely, you need to have a look at my book. I'm sure all of you must be having a copy.
Yes.
So please go to that book, go into the chapter on gyro, right? And in that there are diagrams given. And the flow which I have taken plus the reading which you gentlemen have done is also from the book, right? So this, all the sessions on gyro need to be coupled with the book to give you a better understanding. After that, if you still have doubts, I'm always there. You can always come to me. So can I say that this gyro theory part is clear now?
Yes, sir.
Only thing remaining is errors.
Errors,
which we will take up in the next session, right? In the meantime, you can also read up the text along with the video, and if you have any doubts, you can come to me anytime. Right?
Yes.
Okay, thank you.